प्रोक्ता पुण्य चित्रोत्पलन
नमस्ते, आई संजीव कुमार सगरिया वेलकम यू टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल द जरिया। इन द सीरीज ऑफ आदिभूमि वी कंटिन्यू प्रेजेंटिंग बिफोर यू द लास्ट एपिसोड ऑन डालखाई। Practice of Anuttara Yoga Tantra is divided into two steps that are the step of generation or Utpatti Karma and the step of completion or Nisparna Karma. The first step is generating himself or herself into a deity to achieve mantra body. Some selected Kumaris and young women were protected from their early age for tantric concerts. There were women gurus who were running the tantric ritual congress. In Western Odisha, Kumhari is a popular name, the place where the selected Kumaris were living, for which the place may be called Kumhari. Where the young girls are living is called Dhangiri Basa. The chief means of the tantric path is called deity yoga, which leads the practitioner to attend Buddha form of body. The deity yoga can be classified into six categories. These are action tantric deity yoga, the sound deity yoga, the letter deity yoga, the form deity yoga, the seal deity yoga, and the sign deity yoga. All the six classes of deity yoga come under meditation. The first realization is sameness nature between him and deity. Both are empty of true existence. All phenomena have same nature, and the final nature is emptiness. With this realization, a white moon disk is visualized with resound of deity's mantra. These sounds turn round into the shapes of the letters and form the mantra. The letters radiate beams of light. The lights are reabsorbed into the letters along with the blessing of the God. This is called great exposition of secret mantra. To do this, the practitioner should cite the texts of Varabodhi and Buddha Guhya, who are the important figures in the secret essence lineage in Tibet. It is very important to note here that the names Varabodhi and Vilasavajra related to one person who practiced litany the name of Manjushri in a small island called Dhima in Uddiyana. In Huma Pragana, Dhima is identified as Dhamma. The salient features of this form of meditation are First, dissolution of the profane existence into emptiness. Second, manifestation of the mind realizing enlightenment into a moon disk. Third, manifestation of one's realization in a linguistic form. Fourth, transformation of the letters into a symbol of the deity. Fifth, transformation of the symbol into the bodily form of the deity. And finally, merging of the visualized divine form with the actual divinity. It is observed that Tandhai culture of Western Odisha and deity yoga have some similarity. A secret sadhana is practiced by some lower caste people, which is known as Tandhai. The Shravana Amavasya is known as Harali Amavasya in Western Odisha. On this particular day, a lot of precaution was made to protect ourselves from Tandhai. On this particular day, the witch performed their ritual. In an inquiry that was made about Tandhai, a Gunya of Bir Maharajpur explained to some extent about mantra, which was practicing by Tandhai, consisting into 2.5 pada, but he was reluctant to give further information. It is observed that the Tandhai tradition of Western Odisha was influenced by deity yoga, and the main aim of Tandhai culture of Western Odisha was the transformation of the symbol into the bodily form of the deity, by which the Tandhai able to keep direct relation with the Yogini, Dakini and Sevist Sadhakini, Jakshasini and Rakshasi, who were very powerful spirits living in cremation grounds and mountainous wilds. The Mahayoga and Tantra Yoga suggest that the group tantric rites were essentially non-sectarian, performed by the members of various sects, and were also open to the members of other sects. According to Tibetan sources, Yogini Tantra, Pragya Tantra and Dakini Tantra are the synonymous of Mother Tantra, and the Tandhai tradition of Western Odisha is the primary stage of Dakini Sadhana. Without the blessing of Dakini, the completion of Vajrayana practice is said to be impossible. It is clear that Western interpretations have failed to resolve the many conflicting manifestations of the Dakini. The problems of interpretation are obvious when we survey the usage of the term Dakini in Tibetan Buddhism. In sacred biographies, she is depicted in a personified manner as an unpredictable, semi-wrathful, dancing spirit woman who appears in visions, dreams, or the everyday lives of yoginis. Her behavior changes in various contexts. She may be playful, nurturing, or sharp and wrathful, especially when protecting the integrity of tantric transmission. She also guards the most private details of the practice so that only those with the purest motivation are able to penetrate their essence. Without the blessing of the Dakini, the fulfillment of Vajrayana practice is said to be inaccessible. Tantra is consisting into two parts that are philosophical and practical. The non-tantric vehicle is philosophical and the tantric part is practical. The non-tantric vehicle is the base for understanding tantric practice. एम ऑफ तंत्र इज रियलाइज द पारमिता जान द डिफरेंस इज दैट द रिजल्ट ऑफ तंत्र यील्ड्स मच फास्टर देन पारमिता जान इंद्रियानम मनोनाथ मनोनाथस्तु मारुत मारुतस्य लयनाथ तत्नाथ नतमस्तयेत। दिस स्टेंजा डिफाइन्स द कोहियरेंस बिटवीन मन विंड लय एंड नाद विच इज फॉर्मुलेटेड इन सच वे टू गेट रीड ओवर द इंद्रिय दिच स्टेट्स ऑफ माइंड रेफर टू न्यूरल कोहियरेंस थ्योरी। इन हिंदू तंत्र द ब्रेथ फ्लोज बाय थ्री कंड्यूट्स ईडा पिंगला एंड सुषुम्ना इन द पोजिशन ऑफ स्पाइन। इन द केस ऑफ एसोटेरिक तंत्र द नेम ऑफ कंड्यूट्स इज डिफरेंस रासन लालन एंड अवधूति एंड ऑल्सो मीन्स अनडिसरप्टेड क्लियर विजुअलाइजेशन इज प्रोड्यूस्ड अ ग्रेट एनर्जी इन द चक्र। द सेक्सुअल ब्रीदिंग इज द काइंड ऑफ ब्रेथ साउंड मूवमेंट एंड मेंटल फोकस दैट हैपन्स व्हेन द एवरेज पर्सन हैज अ टाइपिकल एक्साइटिंग एक्सप्लोजिव ऑर्गेजम। द एंशंट एंड मॉडर्न एसरेटिक सेक्ट्स have urged about the consumption of the seminal fluid to improve sexual ability and bodily fitness. The scientific analysis suggests that the sperm seed of man is a treasure house of vitamins, minerals, hormones, proteins, enzymes, iron, and other vital nitration substances. In addition to this, there is an additional property called life force, which is inseparable from the body of human being till to his death. Love making is a powerful healing tonic. It involves in sharing the human life force, which is far more powerful than any harm or medicine. There arises a question, how the dancing style of Dalkhai is related with yoga. Breathing is the most basic function of our body. Without it, all other system of body will be stopped. It starts from birth and continues till the end of life. Still, we are ignored about breathing and sex together and also its role in our sexual life. Guru Ghasiram Mishra suggested that breathing is directly related to our emotion. So the response to any emotion will change our breathing pattern. Body movement is also closely associated with emotions. It is possible to alter our feelings by changing the way our movements. For example, if you dance, you may begin to feel happy. When you feel depressed and down, your shoulders slope and slouch. It's almost impossible to be depressed and stand with your shoulders back and your chest out. The way of breath and the way of movement both affect the way of feeling. This principle is also applicable to our sexual feeling. It can be viewed that dancing style and the poses techniques used by the yogini of Dalkhai is bearing the techniques of control of thought and control of breath. Spirituality and orgasm are different expressions of the same life force. There is a great similarity between intense religious experience and total orgasm. It can be described as peak experience. The giving of oneself to another with love, total surrender, non-dual and merger described the religious experience as well as sexual union. The goal of Tantra Yoga or Mahayoga is to achieve divine union through sexual union. In Tantric ritual, both the partners are considered as divine woman and divine man. In other words, Shakti and Shakta. Without seminal teaching or T-shirt knowledge, to lead into this path of spirituality is impossible. It is very natural that confusion rose in the mind of yogi for losing of energy, which is generated by intense sadhana. So the yogi should have cared for three major controls: the control of thought, the control of breathing, and the control of semen. These preparations for sexual union are enough to lead anyone's mind and body towards divinity. The divine ritual of Tantric Yoga is long and involved. In essence, what takes place is that the Shakta, the male, is seated with a woman, the Shakti. The Shakti may be the man's wife or another woman. For any woman is the living embodiment of Shakti. Each approach is to ritual by meditation and preparation. The preparation is the part of the ritual, and there are a number of steps in the ritual. From cleaning the body to drinking wine and eating meat or flesh. This is followed by each partner's touching the others at various places on their body while chanting a mantra. The final ritual is the joining of the male and the female. The partners sit facing each other. They breathe in unison. As they exhale, they make vibration. They concentrate on the Muladhara Chakra in the area at the base of the spine. When they feel the energy begin to spread, they draw the energy up the spine and send it to their partner. After a length of time, when the male is feeling a great enough flow of energy, he draws the female Shakti onto his lap. She wraps her legs around him and her arms are around his neck, and they are joined but remain motionless. They are joining their eyes and minds. They breathe in unison. They join their foreheads and their eyes merge into one, as do their spirits. You may have seen some of the oriental statues that depict this scene. This in general is the sequence, but it may vary from one devotee to another. The major emphasis is on the physical and spiritual tension, not the genital function. Dalkhai is a tantric rite where the participants were trained to use the most powerful sexual energy for the attainment of higher state of consciousness, by which personal ego is vanished. The sadhaka or divine man, reluctant for union because fear of losing energy which is cultivated by him from intense sadhana, the control of thought, the control of breathing, and the control of semen are the three branches of a tree. The tree is sexual union. Dala means branches of a tree and Khai means consuming. The philosophical and symbolic meaning of Dalkhai is that after consuming of the branches, he means sadhaka becomes the owner of the tree or union. So the word dalkhai refers to the control of thought, breath and semen to attend the final stage of sexual union, which leads the sadhaka to realize all phenomena are void. The main objective of Anuttara Yoga Tantra is the realization of void through the sexual union. With the help of deity yoga, the sadhaka attained the Buddha form of body along with great exposition of secret mantra. The illusory body and Buddha form of body cannot exist separately from each other. In this way, the sadhaka attained the path of wisdom. The deity yoga is the preliminary path of tantric culture. The Abhidhanottarottara text divided into four groups of tantra called as Anuttara Yoga Tantra, Yoga Tantra, Charjya Tantra and Kriya Tantra, which relate to four degrees of passion. These degrees of passion are symbolic in nature and generating Kama Dhatu, as suggested in the Kama Sutra of Vatsyayana. The love making are incitement by rupa, rasa, gandha and sparsa. The sadhaka enjoys joyous bliss that arises from mutual desire, which generates a profound concentration. The mutual desire should be non-conceptual. A profound concentration leads sadhaka or sadhika to the meditative stage where the wind flows from right to left in both sides of central channel. In this process, it enters the central channel of practitioner and dissolves in the crown chakra. This process will formulate bodhicitta drop in the crown chakra, which flows downward and generates four types of joys in the chakra located in the head, throat, heart and navel. Further, when the wind flows in the central channel, it arises three types of light in the chakra and dissolves in the clear light of crown chakra. After visualization of cloudless light, the sadhaka can be realized that all phenomena are void. The cremation grounds and mountainous wilds where the deities of higher tantra dwelt, like Jogini, Dakini, Sadhakini, Jakshasini and Rakshasi, who were very powerful spirits. It is very interesting to note that these locations are also selected for Dalkhai in ancient time. The Savist tradition suggests that the female spirits were particularly associated with Odhyana. The goal is to access the miraculous power and esoteric knowledge of these female spirits. Tandhai is a secret tradition practiced in Western Odisha. The word Tandhai consists of two words from the Sambalpuri language that are Tana and Dhyai, which means body and meditation respectively. By the help of this tradition, the sadhika attained the daivya form of body. Though Tandhai were transforming the symbol into body form by which they were able to keep direct communication with the powerful spirits of cremation ground and mountainous wilds. These divine men and women were the participants of the ancient Dalkhai. The beauty of this culture is incomparable. The series of Adibhumi is continued. We accomplish here our presentation on the topic Dalkhai. The author dedicates this story to Guru Sri Ghasiram Mishra. Further, you are requested to give your comments on this series of Adibhumi. Juhar. I'm
जो उचे झोड़ी।